Destination Moon. Man's eternal dream, the final conquest of outer space, exploration of our nearest planetary neighbour, the Moon. Here the first time anywhere is the prolific story of a science fiction film which is still as timely as today's headlines. Years before, film producer Charles Powell placed actor Rod Taylor in H.G. Wells' time machine, even before he caused worlds to collide or launched a Academy Award-winning Martian invasion on Earth. He determined to take a satellite journey by rocket ship to the Moon. And after 48 months of staggering amount of work and research, Powell's Destination Moon loomed up on the world's theatre screens and rocketed into the permanent niche Hollywood's Motion Picture Hall of Fame. Filmed in Technicolor, gets a beautiful and authentic outer space scenery, designed by technical artist Chesley Bonesteel. Destination Moon held audiences everywhere spellbound. The film even made some Europeans wondering if America actually had landed, reached Luna. The science fiction epic posed tremendous problems for small army technicians who worked on it, and solutions arrived at ingenious ways. Producer untwinkling stars, the inky blackness of space, over 1,000 automobile headlights connected by miles of wire to a backdrop consisting of 400 feet black velvet, life-size spaceship cabin airlock was scientifically constructed on an enormous rotating drum so the actors could walk with a free-fall effect of no gravity. Upwards of 130 men laboured for 2 months to construct the vast and rugged surface of the Moon. The actors themselves had to learn to float in air or walk up walls, as added to efforts by stairway wires and special harnesses to achieve the effect of a crushing acceleration, as the have to readjust themselves to many new experiences ranging from milking of walls and magnetic reading sandwiches upside down while travelling at 7 miles a second. Halfway to the Moon, Discovery frozen radar antenna led three of the astronauts to don their spacesuits and crawl out the ship's hull for repair work. With checking its rocket tubes for possible blast-off damage, Dr. Graves became detached from the hull, and Barnes barely rescued him in time, but using one of Luna's oxygen bottles of a miniature spaceship, utilizing the nozzle of the oxygen tank, he did it after the floating spaceship scientists. They returned them both to the ship. Four adventurers finally landed their rocket lunar crater, having Herpolis high in the northern latitudes of the Moon. A busy exploration pteroid followed. The crew examined the timeless, pitted surface of the Moon, engaged in astrophotography, and check the valuable mineral deposits. Impressions of sights never before seen by human eyes were radioed back to the waiting Earth. At last, the time comes to return to the mother planet, as a horrifying predicament was discovered. The little amount of fuel left in its tanks, Luna was carrying too much weight to fall free of the Moon's gravity. It looked as though one of the spaceshippers would have to remain behind forever. Even when the ship was stripped of every movable object, including radios, it's still many pounds too heavy. As the men discussed their terrifying thought, one of their number remaining on the Moon, Joe Sweeney, the radio man, quietly slipped into the last onboard spacesuit and left the ship voluntary, offering to give up his life so that others could return to Earth. Barnes, a useful industrialist, hit upon the scheme for lighting the ship still further and frankly called Sweeney back. Still in his spaceship, the radio man was instructed to fall a small notch under the outer airlock door. He then attached his suit to the empty oxygen cylinder with a length of rope. Placing the rope in the fouled groove, he hung the cylinder outside the Luna and closed the door. The airlock was moved, pumped full of air, as he removed his 50-pound suit. He retreated to the control room within the door. The inner door was sealed and the outer one over remote control. Vacuum in the airless Moon rushed into the chamber, and a suit was pulled across the floor, out of the ship, by the weight of the heavy oxygen bottle. Collected a sigh of relief, a man closed the outer airlock door for the last time and strapped themselves to their crutches. The Lunas rose on a towering column of orange flame, plunging into space, heading for Mother Earth and home, and to the cheers of enthusiastic moviegoers. Man who made it all possible, the talented George Powell.